District Attorney Pierson, big win for this effort that you are backing to reform Prop 47, but this is just one aspect of this, and this is not the first time that folks have tried to reform Prop 47 over the years. So what's different this time around?
Well, the biggest thing that's different is we really went into this as a bipartisan, a collaborative effort, saying we understand and recognize what the problems are in California. We have a 50% increase in homelessness in the last 10 years. We have drug addiction and drug overdoses exploding, people dying from fentanyl, and we have massive increases in theft, not just retail theft, but theft overall. So how can we address it? And what we tried to do in putting this initiative together is to try to put something together that would appeal to both sides of the aisle, not just a Republican measure or not just a Democrat measure, but both sides of the aisle in a comprehensive way. And I think we've been pretty effective. If you look at, we have Mayor London Breed out of San Francisco, Matt Mahan out of San Jose, a number of other mayors that are on the front line of dealing with these problems have all endorsed this initiative. And yet here now, as we qualify it for the to be on the ballot, we have the legislature and administration, the senior leadership, pushing back and saying, whoa, we're afraid to let the voters decide this question for themselves. We need to do something different.
Yeah, and we're going to talk about, that's going to be just a tease ahead, that's going to be the second half of our show, is on this feuding happening in the legislature between Republicans and Democrats surrounding this initiative. But I want to ask you specifically, because I saw your comments earlier in the week, and you basically said this package of bills that the legislature is working on and this ballot measure, let's do both of them. Why do you feel that way?
Let's do both. We support the 14 different bills, each in their way, they do things that are positive here in the state of California. I think more could be done, but I certainly support each of those different measures. And then you set aside that and look over at the initiative. There's nothing that is in conflict between the two. They work very well together. And when the legislative leadership brought up concerns about it, and they were pressed, they kept saying, well, there's a conflict. And the media rightly said, what's the conflict? The best thing that they came up with was saying, well, the initiative doesn't have the inflation escalator that one of the bills has when it goes over $50,000.
Yeah, to deal with inflation, right? That was one of the aspects that the speaker's office brought up. But in their package of bills, it doesn't address fentanyl, right? And this initiative would handle that. And when you mention those mayors, London Breed, Matt Mahan, I want to bring in Todd Gloria out of San Diego too. That is one of the biggest issues. We saw the governor this week deploy more National Guard troops to the border to deal with fentanyl. So this is an issue that is obviously big for the state of California.
Yeah, fentanyl is rampant in California, and people are dying. In my El Dorado County, during the Super Bowl, a small Super Bowl party, four people died from an overdose of fentanyl. It is everywhere that people are dying from it. Oftentimes, they don't realize that what they're consuming is fentanyl. And we need to do something much more seriously than what we have been doing. And yes, that is part of the initiative and a very important part of what we need to fix here in California.
All right, so Democrats who oppose this, I just want to get your take on this, say that this is just going to compound on each other and it's going to lead to more black and brown people being incarcerated. Is that the goal here?
It is not the goal. And to be very clear, I heard the claims of mass incarceration. Obviously, they haven't read the initiative. The initiative in no way, shape, or form brings back the era with the so-called era of mass incarceration. On the third time in terms of property crime, it can be a felony. On the third time in terms of hardcore drugs, it can be a felony. But it's a treatable felony, and we're going to bring back the drug courts where the judge has the ability to say, you need to go to rehab. If you go to rehab, your conviction will be expunged. If you refuse to go to rehab, yes, you will get a felony conviction. That's a trade-off. These are not it's a silly argument to bring up mass incarceration if you've actually read The nature of the bill. The bill is, or the initiative. The initiative is very narrow, very specific to dealing with the problem that we're dealing with, which is homelessness, drug addiction, and rampant theft here in California.
Okay, so I want to finally ask you this. I might already know the answer to this question, considering the direction our conversation has gone. There is still some time for negotiations to happen to pull this initiative off the ballot. Do you see both parties coming to the table and finding some sort of compromise?
Well, I'm pessimistic at this point, and I'll tell you the reason why. Sheriff Jim Cooper, myself, a host of other people have been saying, if you want to fix Prop 47, you have to go back to the voters. We've brought this up for months, and we have been stonewalled. There's been no effort, no interest whatsoever on the part of the legislature, legislative leadership, to put this back in front of the voters, which it needs to be. We don't have to say Prop 47 was terrible and we need to repeal it. Everybody, across the spectrum, recognizes there's problems with Prop 47 that needed to be fixed, long overdue to go back and fix it. It's time we do it now.
All right. District Attorney Vernon Pierson, appreciate the conversation and your time here on Inside California Politics.
Thank you very much.